Hello! So before we start, please like this video and subscribe to this channel. Thank you so much. So for the problem that we're going to solve in this video, so this is about classification of soil using the soil classification systems that we have, which is AASHTO and USCS. So for this problem, we're going to classify the following soil. So we have here soil A and soil B. So andito yung data for soil A and soil B. So we're going to write each condition that is satisfied for each classification. So for number one, we're going to classify soil A using AASHTO method. So for this video, we're only going to classify soil A. So we're going to classify soil B on a separate video. So for this video, we're going to classify soil A. So this is the data for soil A using AASHTO. So for AASHTO class, so this is the table that we're going to use. Okay? So this is table 5.1. So in this table, we're going to determine the group classification. So here in AASHTO, we are to classify the soil, we are identifying the group classification. So here in the upper table, so these are the classification from A1A to A27, and then here in the lower table, so the group classifications here are A4 up to A7. So after we determine the group classification of the soil, the next thing that we have to determine is the group index. So later on, we're going to determine that and discuss that, kung ano ba yung group index. Okay, anyway, so for soil A, so again, ito yung data natin, half for soil A. So the first thing that we have to do here, class, we have to identify if the soil is granular material or silt clay material. So it is granular material if the sieve or the passing to sieve number 200 is 35 or less. Okay, 35% or less. And on the other hand, it is silt clay material if the passing number 200 is more than 35%. So with that, we have to check first, from our data. So for soil A, so the percent finer here for sieve number 200 is, as you can see, this is 33%. Okay, so we have here 33%. Alright, so since the passing to sieve number 200 is 33%, so that means na ang nasatisfy niya, class, is ito, 35% or less, since 33%. So sulat natin, so sabi yun sa instruction that we have to write each condition that is satisfied. So for sieve number 200, the passing is 33. Okay, so this satisfies the conditions that it is less than or equal 35%, Okay, so nasatisfy ito. So therefore, class, we know that this soil is granular material, right? And so this is granular material. So we're going to identify the group classification of the soil here in the upper table. So class, yung pagka-classify natin dito, we start from left to right. So mag-i-start tayo from A1A. So check natin yung mga kailangan natin dito. So we need here sieve number 10, and kailangan, class, hindi siya lumagpas ng 50 since we have here 50 max. So check natin yung sieve number 10. So yung nag-pass through sa sieve number 10 natin, class, ay 77. Okay, so class, lumagpas siya sa 50. So that means hindi na ito yung group classification natin. So mag-proceed tayo sa A1B. So check natin yung nag-pass through sa sieve number 40. Dapat daw hindi siya lalagpas ng 50 since this is 50 max. Okay, for sieve number 40, the percent finer is 51. Okay, so in this case, class, hindi rin siya pasok because lumagpas siya, it exceeds 50. So hindi rin ito. So definitely mag-move tayo dito sa A3. So for A3 ang kailangan natin for sieve number 40, the passing to sieve number 40, it has to be 51 and above since this is 51 minimum. So check natin yung sieve number 40. So 51, so actually pasok siya, So it satisfied that condition. Okay, so after you after this, i-determine mo naman yung sieve number 200. No, yung sieve number 200 natin, yung passing dapat daw dyan ay 10. Max, so hindi siya lalagpas ng 10. But in this case, yung nag-pass through sa sieve number 200 natin ay 33. So, hindi siya pasok dito sa 10 max, right? Kasi lumagpas. So, hindi ito class yung group classification natin. So, move tayo dito sa A24. So, for A24, yung sieve number 200 daw dapat ay 35. But in this case, yung sieve number 200 natin, 33. So, pasok naman. Nasatisfy naman siya. So, move tayo dito sa liquid limit niya sa baba. So, yung liquid limit daw dapat ay 40 max. So, in this case, ang liquid limit natin, 46. So, it exceeds 40. So, hindi rin ito class yung classification natin, no? So, move tayo dito sa A25. So, dito, na-determine na natin na pasok siya dito. Sa liquid limit, hindi siya pasok dito. Pasok ba siya? Pasok pala siya. Liquid limit natin, 41 minimum. So, yung liquid limit natin ay 46. So, pasok siya. No? Pero yung plasticity index, check natin. Ang plasticity index natin ay 10 max. So, yung plasticity index natin actually, yan ay LL minus PL, right? So, LL 46 minus PL, which is 29. Yan class ay, ilan yun? 46 minus 29. Yan ay 17. So, kung 17 yung PI natin, okay, as you can see here, hindi rin siya pasok dito kasi 10 max ito, lumagpas siya sa 10, no? 17 kasi yung PI eh. No, so, hindi rin siya dito. So, check natin dito sa A26. So, pasok siya sa 35, kaya lang di siya pasok sa 40 max, di ba? Na-check na natin yan kanina kasi yung PL, yung LL natin ay 46. So, hindi ito yon. So, baka dito na siya sa A27, check natin. So, 35 yung maximum. So, pasok tayo dyan. 41 yung minimum for LL. Pasok tayo dyan. 11 yung minimum for PI. Pasok tayo dyan. So, plus yung mga conditions na nasatisfy is under dito sa A27. So, that means class na yung soil natin ay A27. So, class, we have to, ano ha, to write each condition na nasatisfy. So, isulat natin yung mga condition na nasatisfy. So, para sa sieve number 200, sulat ulit natin ang ano natin dyan ay 33. Tapos, 35 yung maximum. So, ibig sabihin, pasok class yung ano natin, no, yung data natin, pasok dyan, since hindi naman siya lumagpas sa 35. Actually, ano yan, no, less than or equal. Okay, so, pasok siya sa 35 max yung 33. And then, yung LL natin, okay, yan ay, okay, lagyan natin to, okay. Tapos, yung LL natin, di ba, 46. Okay, tapos pasok siya class sa minimum natin. So, yung minimum natin, so 41 yan, no? So, pasok siya kasi mas malaki ang 46 kasi sa 41. So, ibig sabihin, okay din ito, na-satisfy yan. And dun sa plasticity index natin, so, dinetermine na natin yan kanina, 17. Tapos yung minimum, 11. No, 11 yung minimum natin. So, ibig sabihin, pasok siya, no? Mas malaki yung 17 kesa sa 11 na minimum. So, pasok. Okay, so ito class ay okay. Okay, so class here, ano na, no, we can say na yung group classification natin dito ay A27, no. So class, pero hindi pa ito yung final ano ha, classification according dito sa AASHTO kasi kailangan pa nating i-determine yung GI niya or yung group index niya na isasama natin dito. No, it has to be enclosed by a parenthesis. No? So, i-determine natin yung group index. So, to determine the group index, ito yung formula natin. So, ito yung complete formula for group index. Itong nauna. Yung GI is equal to F sub 200 minus 35 times 0.2 plus 0.005 LL minus 40 plus 0.01 F200 minus 15 PI minus 10. No? And then, we also have here the partial group index. So, ang partial group index natin ay ito lang, 0.01 F200 minus 15 times PI minus 10. So, in this case, class, meron tayong rule. Kapag yung group classification natin ay nag-fall under A1A hanggang A25, automatic yung group index natin ay 0. Okay, take note of that half from here to here, yung GI natin automatic 0. A1A hanggang A25. Tapos class, yung rule natin, kapag nandito siya sa A26 at A27, yung group index na gagamitin natin is yung partial. Partial group index. So, yung partial group index natin, again, ay ito ha. Ito yun. Okay, ito yun. Yung nasa baba. Ito. Okay, so kapag naman nandito, nag-fall, ito na yung complete GI na yung dinedetermine natin dyan. So, in this case, class, since yung group classification natin nag-fall under A27. So, yung i-compute natin na group index ay partial group index. At ito yung formula natin. So, isulat natin dito. Yan ay GI is equal to 0.01. And then F200 class, yung F200 dito is yung percent finer, no, or yung lumusot, yung nag-pass through sa sieve number 200. So yung nag-pass through sa sieve number 200 sa atin ay 33%. Tama. So i-substitute na natin agad, no. So 33 yung nag-pass through sa sieve number 200 minus 15. And then yung PI natin 17, no, yung na-compute natin minus 10. So we can now compute yung GI natin dito. So compute natin. Sige, pakita natin sa calculator. All right. So yan ay 0.01 times 33 minus 15, okay, times 17 minus 10. So, yung lumalabas class na sagot dito for group index ay 1.26, no? So, class, meron tayong rule for group index na kapag may decimal siya, di ba, gagawin natin, ira-round off natin siya. Tama? So, in this case, class, rounding this off, so this will be, ano, no, 1. Equal to 1. So, rule natin yan. So, yung GI natin, class, ay 1. Kailangan whole number yung GI natin, ha? Okay, so in this case, class, we can say na yung group index, andito siya 1. No? So, i-enclose natin yung class by a parenthesis. Tapos, itatabi mo yan dun sa final group classification natin. So, ito na, class, yung final classification ng soil natin according to AASHTO. So, if we're going to interpret yung nakuha natin, no, so since dito siya nag-fall sa 827, no, so yung rating natin or yung general subgrade rating natin kapag nandito siya, class, is from excellent to good. No, kapag nandito siya sa upper table natin, no. So we can say na yung soil A natin, yung subgrade rating niya is excellent to good, no, to be used as a highway subgrade material. Okay.